Vespers. Know that I have this on the schedule for this day, and that His Eminence Metropolitan Salas desperately wanted to spend time with the children at camp. So he is doing Vespers as we speak. He is studying Vespers at the Metropolis so that he can participate with the virtual summer camp children on the last day of their program. So it frees us up to do the service, not in camp style, but the way it's supposed to be done according to the book. So we will follow that this evening. The service text is, of course, listed in your in the Facebook Live so that you can follow along. Blessed is God, always now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Come, let us worship and bow down before God our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ God our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Him, Christ our King and God. Blessed, O Lord, my soul, O Lord, my God, you are magnified exceedingly. You clothe yourself with thanksgiving and majesty. You cover yourself with light as with a garment. You stretch out the heavens like a curtain. You are He who covers His upper chambers with water, who makes the world. Calls his means of approach, walks on the wings of the winds, who makes his angel spirits and his ministers a flame of fire. He established the earth on a stable foundation, and shall not be moved into the ages of ages. The deep like a garment is his covering, the water shall stand upon the mountains. Anger be moved, they shall feel the sound of your thunder, they shall be afraid. The mountains rise up, and the plains sink down to the place you founded for them. He set a boundary, they shall not pass over, neither shall they return to cover the earth. You are He who sends springs into the valley, and the waters shall pass between the mountains. They shall give drink to all the wild animals in the field. The wild donkeys shall quench their thirst. The birds of heaven shall dwell beside them. They shall sing from the midst of the rocks. You are He who waters the mountains from His higher places. The earth shall be satisfied with the fruit of your works. You are He who causes grass to grow for the cattle and the green plant for the service of man. For to bring forth bread from the earth and wine from God and sour man. She brightened his face with oil and bread, strengthened his man's heart. The trees of the plain shall be full of fruit, the seedless of Lebanon which you planted. Then the spirit shall make their nest, the house of the heron takes meat among them. The high mountains are for the deer, the cliff is a refuge for the rabbits. He made the moon for seasons, the sun knows its setting, the star established darkness in his night, wherein all wild animals of the forest will crawl about. The young lions, wine, snatch, and grain seek their food from God. The sun rises, and they are gathered together, and they shall be put to bed in their beds. And to fall out to his work and to his labor and to evening. Lord, your work shall be magnified greatly, and you made all things in wisdom. The earth was filled with your creation, there is as great as spacious sea. The creeping things are there without number, the living things are there both small and great. There are those ships passed through, there is this dragging way from the earth. You all things wait upon you that you may give them food in due season. When you give it to them, they shall gather, when you open your hand, all things shall be filled with your goodness. But when you turn your face away, they shall be troubled. When you take away their God, they shall die and return again to their dust. You shall send forth your spirit, they shall be created, you shall renew the face of the earth. Let the born Lord be forever, the Lord shall be God in his works. He looks upon the earth and makes it tremble, he touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord all my life, I will sing to my God as often as I exist. May my words be pleasing to him, and I shall be God in the world. May the sinners cease from the earth and the law so as to be no more blessed, Lord, on my soul. The sun knows its setting, you establish darkness in his night. The Lord your word shall be magnified, may all things of wisdom. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and to the Lord, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to God. Alleluia, 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 glory to God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, God. Our own Lord, glory to you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Above for salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace in the whole world, for the stability of all the churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter it with faith ourselves to one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Lord, make me lie so mean, hard to be humble and contrite. Grant me to make a complete confession of the sinful actions of my entire life, that I may bless the remainder of my life in repentance, with your help and obtain the remission of all my sins.
For with the Lord there is mercy, and with him is abundant redemption, and he shall redeem Israel from all his transgressions. O Master, be clothed with your mantle, saying with your power from on high, which is truly invincible, and thus you enabled him to endure the tortures. For you, as martyr, when lawlessness tormented him, and to receive halos for his martyrdom. O Jesus, the Almighty Savior of our souls, we implore you, grant the forgiveness of all our sins at the prayers of Emilian.
Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles, praise him, all you people. Set a fire with zeal for thee, and being armored with the Holy Cross, I press with your Almighty Lord, and kindled up forever all the idols that was glorious and mighty, and also soothe the poor loud ranks of the first author and cause of wickedness, and hath received the kingdom of the heavens from thee, O Master Christ, as the prize of his victory, and he prayeth that we be saved.
For his mercy was over us, and the truth of the Lord endures forever. O Lord, O Lord, you have added to the church's firmament your sublime holy martyr Emilian. He shines like a brilliant star as a sterling soldier, lighting up the whole world with mystic miracles and signs. He drives away the darkness of godlessness. O
And his say.
together with you, we also may be shepherded beside us in the water of us.
Blessed are they whom you have chosen to receive the Lord, and their memorial abides from generation to generation among the spirits of the righteous perfected in faith. Give rest, O Savior, to the souls of your servants, keeping them in the blessed life which is from you, O loving one.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
both now and ever, and through the ages of ages. Amen.
Having you, O Theotokos, as our hope and protection, we are not dismayed by the schemes of the foe, for truly you save our souls.
Please be seated just for a moment. Because of Julian. And Julian is one of them. being a Christian just long enough to take a hammer and smash statues of idols. Just long enough to make sure that everyone knew that Christ will not share time. Christ will not. Our Lord Jesus Christ will not share time or attention with anyone. He will not. Then he was found. And when he was found, he was happy to go. Okay, I did what I need. It's not time for me to go. It's not time for me to go about my business and give him, not only give my actions to Christ, but now I'm going to give my last breath to him. He was tortured. He was beaten. And his flesh was stripped of his body by whips, to the point where he was bleeding profusely, but that did not end his life. Or at least so they thought. They weren't done torturing him. They were going to throw him on a fire. He was happy to become a whole burnt offering for the Lord. He was happy to be the final incense of the Lord. Unfortunately for those that wished to see him burn alive, his blood extinguished the fire. And God allowed him to repose peacefully. Not as a result of the torture, although you can say he bled to death. But that's not the way the Sinai Studies tells the story. He was able to surrender his own soul to God rather than to have it taken from him. It's important that we understand that when we live our life for God, dictate the terms of our death. It's kind of cool. I've been around it a few times. People who have kind of waited for their departure from this earth. Waited until things were just settled. And then God accepted their soul. It's one of the few times that we actually get to, not necessarily get to choose when we die. God already knows, but he'll let us. He'll let us wait until things are just so. When we live our life for Christ, sometimes those things are allowed. It's a beautiful thing when we get to see them first again. A loved one that passes away only when all of their family members are present, right? You know, a person that breathes their last, only when this person forgave another person. These things are not common among those who believe in Christ. We need to find comfort in the lives of the saints. We need to find their stories not just to be gruesome because of their torture, but to be encouraging in a world that is increasingly becoming more angry, increasingly becoming so much more tolerable and not just accepting of other people's faiths. People can believe whatever they want. But putting weight in what they believe. As if the God that existed throughout all time and eternity is not the God that we actually believe in. But maybe there's someone else. It can't be us. It can never be us. And we have people like Saint Emilianos, this wonderful young martyr, who would not allow Julian to make his God second to anyone. We have examples such as this to remind us how important it is to make our Lord here. And only when he's here, anything else St. Emilian had God first, and then knew what he had to do. Let us make our Lord that priority, using the example of St. Emilian today and throughout our lives. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. light to bring revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, forgive our sins, and us, according to our transgressions. Holy One, is in the one for peace, for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
That is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Property to the monastery, ask that the monastery be named.
monastery has kind of existed since its inception in kind of a, it has a dual feast. So the kind of the guest house facilities were kind of named for the prophet Elijah, and the main monastery was consecrated, well, not really consecrated, but blessed under the nativity of the Theotokos. So we kind of do both feasts. But this coming Monday is that, and so I will be attending service out there, safely, of course. We don't want to pass coronavirus or whatever we have along. And then on the 26th, I will be away, but we will have a visiting priest coming in. I won't tell you who that is. You'll see him on the day. So, or maybe I'll announce it somewhere soon. But other than that, God bless you. Have a wonderful and blessed rest of your evening. Thank you, Sava, for chanting, and may the Lord continue to bless and guide all of us. Amen.